As you know, we've been discussing kinetic theory of matter, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
And we've talked on how we can use kinetic theory of matter to explain some gas law, right?
Yes, sir.
We've talked on how we can use kinetic theory of matter to explain Boyle's law, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
In that theory, we made mention that the more the pressure increases, the smaller the what?
Volume.
The volume, God bless you. So today we want to look at another law. We want to look at how we can use kinetic theory to explain Charles what? Charles what? This is what? This is Charles law. Charles law states that the volume of a given mass of gas, isn't it, is directly proportional to its what? To its temperature. Provided that what? The pressure remains constant. And like I used to tell you, if you from the law states that the volume, you can put this in mathematically, isn't it? We can put this thing mathematically. Charles was telling us that the volume of a given mass of gas, which we are going to represent with what? V, isn't it? He says it's directly proportional, right?
Yes.
To its what?
To
its temperature. That is what? We are representing our temperature with what? Letter what? Letter C. So we have, this is the mathematical expression of what Charles is telling us. That is, the volume of a given mass of gas is directly proportional to what? To its temperature. So let's now form an equation with this thing. To remove the proportionality sign, so what do we do to this equation? That is, we multiply this thing with what? With a constant. And we are using our constant as what? As k. So once we multiply this sign with the constant, which is what? Our k, the proportionality sign is what? We remove, isn't it? So with that, we have v equals what? T what? Tk, isn't it? And we've not finished, we are not done with this equation yet. Are we going to go? All we need now to do is to make what? The k, the what? The subject. So if you are making the k the subject, that means we will divide what? We divide both sides. By what? By what? By coefficient. By the coefficient of what? Of t, isn't it?
Yes.
The coefficient of t here is k, isn't it?
Yes.
So what are we going to? We divide both sides by t. Sorry, we divide both sides by what? By t, and that one will give us what? V over what? Over t equals what? T k all over what? T, isn't it?
Yes.
And this one will what? We cancel this one. So the first one will now be what? K equals what? V all over what? T. So this is what? The Charles law equation. Now, let's now assume that the gas that we are talking about here has initial what? Volume and the initial what? Temperature. In other words, that means we are going to have the initial volume. We can say our initial volume is what? V1, isn't it?
Yes.
And we can also say, okay, initial volume, I mean, initial temperature of the gas is also what? T1. That gas can have a change in volume from this initial volume. Once we increase the what? The temperature to a final what? Volume. And the temperature, since we've increased the temperature from its initial temperature, the temperature will also change to another what? Temperature, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Like if we start boiling water now, the initial volume of that, the gas, the steam of that water will be our what? V1, isn't it?
Yes.
And the initial temperature will also be what? T1. By the time we boil this thing, the volume of the steam must have